Hello, fellow foreign language teachers, it's Tatiana Skripkina, and you're watching my YouTube channel, which is for the teachers of foreign languages. And today I'm going to talk about how to begin to present at EFL conferences and what to expect when you apply. Well, first of them, you should find a conference and find out if they have call for papers. You may use Google as a tool, or you may follow my Facebook page where I post always when I see some calls for papers. So please read all the information which is written about the conference, and then you should fill in the application form. About what to expect in the application form, I will tell you a little bit later. And so you fill in the application form, there you will write the abstract about your presentation, and be sure that you do not bite more than you can chew. So do not promise the things which you will not be able to present if you are chosen for the conference. Be sure to ask if they pay for your trip, if it is in another country, and if you as a presenter have to pay the fee for speaking or taking part at a conference. Equipment, if they do not write any information about equipment, so ask them if they provide a laptop, if they have overhead projector which you may need for your presentation, and also if you have some handouts, be sure to ask them about it. If they can print it, or you should bring them with you, because for example, if you expect 100 people for your workshop and you have 4 different handouts, so you will have to have about 400 handouts. And if they cannot print them for you, so you will have to bring from your country to the conference, which might be not suitable for you at all. So be sure to ask some questions if you have before applying for the for your presentation. And also talking about the number of people, you should ask how many people approximately you will have at your talk or at your workshop, just to know if for example you have handouts, how many handouts you should print and prepare beforehand. So talking about application forms, there are some common questions which they ask in the application form. So the first ones is that you should state your name, surname, where you work, country, city, address, telephone number, email, probably Skype if they would like to talk to you before the conference. And you should sometimes state how long you have been teaching and about your teaching experience, and probably some qualifications which you have. Topic of your presentation, a type of your presentation, if it is a research-oriented presentation, talk, workshop, or if it is a demo lesson. And also usually they state how much time it lasts. So for example, if it is a demo lesson, they may state that it's 30 minutes, or if it is a workshop, it's 80 minutes. And so be sure that you know what to do, for example, during your workshop, which lasts 80 minutes. Summary of your presentation. They also state how many words they expect you to write this summary. For example, if it is 100 words, so you should send them the summary within 100 words. If it's 500, then it's 500 words. Also, it is very important that you ask or you write in the application, if they ask to, the working language. If it is English, so you state that the working language is English, because sometimes at international conferences they have different sections with different working languages. So be sure, you should be sure about it. Also, they may ask why you consider this topic to be important and why you are confident to present it. So that may be significant for them. And also, they may ask you about equipment, as I have mentioned before, and if they do not ask about it, so please be sure to ask them. For example, if you need internet connection, so and you cannot conduct the workshop without internet connection, so it might be really, really awful. And also, the rubric I have mentioned before, you just mention if it's a talk or a workshop, and if it is workshop, be sure that you have some activities and your workshop really looks like a workshop and not as a talk, because it's really annoying when you expect a workshop and you come and the presenter just gives a talk, so it doesn't make much sense. I think I have told you everything about it, but if I haven't, please do not hesitate and ask me questions, leave comments, and of course remember to subscribe my YouTube channel to get more video and tips for language teachers. I wish you an amazing day, and let's keep in touch and see you later.